Hi, welcome to Stars TV after the Coventry game with Coach Dan Ceman. Dan, that wasn't a game where we weren't getting forward and creating chances. You know, there were a lot of shots on goal. We had the puck in the net twice, obviously disallowed goals. So what's the problem? I mean, we are creating chances, but there's no goals.
Well, today we lacked finish around the net. It's been an issue off and on, mostly on all season, and we just didn't put the puck away when we had quality chances. We had several. We had a post. We had, like you said, a disallowed goal, but we're just not taking our chances well enough. Like you said, I thought we played well enough to be effective. We were effective in spurts. We kind of had some letdown periods, especially in the second period. I thought we stopped skating for a bit, yeah, we played well enough to score some goals today and make that game a game to that we might have had a chance to get a point on or two, but yeah, we're not finishing.
Yeah, I suppose from an outsider looking in at some of our results lately, you'd start to wonder, you know, if the coach's patience is just going to run out and he's going to snap, you know. But is it a case of you've just got to keep plugging at it to make it better?
Well, yeah, I mean, there's been times where both me and Husey have snapped this year, and the guys have responded very well. We've had some really poor performances, and the guys have redeemed themselves and played really hard after that. But I don't think tonight is a game where you can start screaming and yelling at players. Guys were playing hard for the most part. I thought we were a bit stagnant to start the game. We were nervous. We iced the puck three times in the first two shifts. It was just, it looked like we were nervous. We have to be ready right at the drop of the puck. We're a little, like I said, we're a little stagnant to start games right now, and it's nerves, I think. But it's not a game where I can there'd be anything accomplished by screaming and yelling. I thought Husey and Hutchins and Dolan, especially Husey and Hutchins, had great games today. They generated a lot of chances. I thought my line wasn't that effective. I was a little disappointed with the play of my line, but. I mean, Husey and Hutchie had enough chances to win that game single-handedly, I think, today. But, I mean, you just have to keep giving the guys who deserve credit, and hopefully they start scoring some goals. We're going to tweak things as we normally do, and we have some different systems, little tweaks to our systems that we're going to play against the different systems that Edinburgh play tomorrow, and we just have to keep our heads up and keep grinding away and play a really emotional, hard game tomorrow.
Yeah. Is there any sort of sense that when you come into a game against a Coventry or a Cardiff or a Nottingham or Sheffield, that you can come up with reasons why we didn't play as well as them? But is there any sense where you have to just take away the reasons and say they are a bigger club than us, they have crowds double, triple what we get, they've got more money, and sometimes you just can't compete against a team of that quality?
Well, I think that's one reason why we've been so good against the top teams, because we know we're a huge underdog. We know that they have a much bigger budget than us, but we feel like we can play with them.
Yeah.
And I mean, that's a motivating factor for us, that we want to play even better against those teams. But like I've said before, we have to take care of business when we play the teams with budgets similar to ours. Mm-hmm. That's even more important, much more important actually, because I don't see, the teams, Hull and Fife and Brayhead have won a couple, but against the top teams, but we've had just as much success or more than any of the teams kind of in our similar budget area. But It's hard to make excuses though, because last year there were times where we were just happy to keep it close against some of the big teams. That is not how we think this year. We still think that we go in to win every game, and we've had some great performances against good top teams, but tonight it just wasn't quite there. We didn't get some luck around the net, but we just have to keep finding ways to score. We work on it, and I think we can get a little bit more, or a lot more desire around the net. Yeah. There's sometimes when we work, get the puck to a shooting position up at the point today where it was open a lot, and then a shot comes and we don't have that little extra battle to get to the front of the net, and the goalie sees it, and most of the goalies in this league are going to make those saves when they see the puck well. So get to the net harder, and there was a few times today where we gambled a little bit offensively, we just have to play great defense against these teams, and we have wits there to save us time and time again, but we can't give them those big opportunities.
Tomorrow in Edinburgh, obviously we beat them 7-3 last time at Murrayfield, and it's historically always been a good place for Stars to go. I'd be inclined to say that if we'd got the puck on net as many times as we did tonight, as we when we played Edinburgh last time, we probably would have won that game quite heavily.
Yeah, well, I think that 7-3 game worked to our disadvantage a little bit because the next game here, we thought that we would have an easy game and win by several goals again. So we can't start thinking about the chance to blow anybody out because it just doesn't look like it's going to happen in any game. We have to work so hard for every goal. But like I said last week, we just have to think about grinding it out, getting our opportunities, and not giving Edinburgh's big line their chances. It's all about creating offense. I thought we did a really good job of cycling the puck. We got pucks in, and we controlled pucks in their end against Coventry, who's a pretty good team. So if we get pucks deep, control the puck, don't throw away pucks with blind passes, and just generate offense when it's there in the offensive zone and own that offensive zone tomorrow. That's the key to the game.
Yeah. All right, Dan, good luck for tomorrow.
Okay.
Thanks for your time.
Thank you.